that's the team that keeps getting better with their football. I will come back, talk about Cape Verde, they defeated South Tome, 7-1. Burkina Faso defeated Comoros 2-0. South Africa and Gambia played a goalless draw. The coach doesn't like it. He's been talking tough. Senegal defeated Burundi 3-1. Mali won over South Sudan 2-0. Algeria defeated Seychelles 4-0. Mozambique lost to Rwanda. That goal was scored in about 4 minutes
in the first half
into the game, and then Rwanda just borrowed Jose Mourinho's bus and packed it. And that's it for their 3 points. Cameroon defeated Mauritania by a single goal. I think Ghana also defeating Mauritius, massive 7-1 also. Yep. So that's it. Some of the results from the 2017 African Cup of Nations qualifiers. Before I go talk about Cape Verde, well, let me talk to you about the Super Eagles team again. Let's talk about some of the new guys. Leon Balogun has played before, but this is his first time playing on home soil. We saw him, not that bad. Talk to me about William Ekong and Madu Kingsley.
Well, Ekong, the guy playing, like you said, playing his debut for the Super Eagles. Mm. You know, the first 10 minutes was a bit jittery, but he managed to, you know, come into the game with Kenneth Omero. He made, you know, some crucial, you know, saves for us. He marked very well. I think we need some height in the central defense. Omero is 6'1". He's 6'3". Mm. So I think we need, but what we need is that for such players to consolidate on their performance. You know, when you are coming from Europe, you play in Kaduna with a high temperature and a terrible pitch. You cannot really blame some of the players because they are used to some of the best pitches in the world. So let's see how it goes. But for Kingsley Madu too, I think he also did well, especially moving up front, trying to come back.
Yeah.
You know, so I think I want to rate them well. You know, but you see, the opposition is Chad. That for me is a source of worry. We don't need to struggle. You see, what I watched the game between Ghana and Mauritius in Kumasi. You see, right from the blast of the whistle, the Ghanaians, you know, dominated play.
But a lot of people argue that their regulars were there. There was Azerbaijan, most of the players. No Mikel Obirie, no Emenike.
Which regulars? A player, the coach invited a player from MLS. Another 20-year-old player from
but
Denmark.
But the core of the Ghanaian team, Ghana is not rebuilding.
Just three new guys started. I mean, Ekong, Madu, and then I think
A City, yeah. City.
You know, Leobalogo has played this Leobalogo third game on the bounce. So
but about seven new defense line Leobalogo is playing.
Maybe with. Madu, then you know, Ekong, Pierre Kenneth, Leobalogo played against Uganda, played against South Africa, the middle of the park, Onazi, A City, then maybe Rabi Ibrahim. They're going forward, Aaron Salami and Odio Ngalo, and also Bartoli has been part of the team since for a very long time. So, I mean, just like Oye State, when you play against Egypt will not give you a chance to come back in second and started playing, started dominating. You need to be strong for the whole 90. You need to get everything right for the duration of the game. You don't play against Egypt even in your home ground. Look jittery and look porous in the first half, and you think you have a chance in the second half. They might punish you like 3 goes up, and you find it very difficult to even get a point.
Mm. But I think for Coach Steven Keshi and this team, there are positives. For us, I think we should just put this team together and sustain it.
Yeah, I think going forward, Keshi should realize that he said that they were going to play sexy football. You see, in Africa, when you are playing,
Rabiu showed us.
When you are playing against Egypt, South Africa, you know the mentality is almost like the Europeans. You can play sexy football. When you are playing Chad, you know these are people who are used to difficult terrain. They are rugged. It was obvious. They wanted to crush us. When you go to N'Djamena, it's going to be worse because even the coach said that the pitch at Ahmed Bello Stadium, as terrible as it was, is that it's good for them. That they don't have that kind of a pitch in Chad.
Oh,
you know, so he needs to balance his team selection. When he's going to such terrains, you get rugged players. You see, you need to crush your opponents.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we don't need Lily Livard. And
Bola
Salami demonstrated it.
Yeah.
The two goals we got, you know, we are sheer grit.
Mm.
You know, if you don't have such players who are committed, patriotic, then you can't get the desired results. So for Keshi, I think this game is an eye-opener.
Mm-hmm.
That anybody, any country that is playing Nigeria now wants to, you know, make history out of Nigeria. So he needs to be on his toes, get the right selection. The players, you see, Aaron Samuel, permit me to say, Aaron Samuel, you know, was the last to come to camp. And he started the game. It was obvious that perhaps jet lag, he played on Saturday, 90 minutes, boarded the plane immediately, got to Nigeria almost 24 hours later. And it's going to be difficult for him to adapt. You know, we had other players who could have started that game. So
who have been in camp for a long time.
So he needs to balance all these issues to get the best out of these players. You know, we don't need to gamble. We want to be in Gabon. You know, the heartache of missing out of Equatorial Guinea is still fresh. You know, so he needs to get it right. We are giant of Africa. We don't want to be sleeping giants. We must crush our opponents like Ghana did to Mauritius. You know. After the game, the Chadians were, rebuffing our players because they felt they could have won. But if you had crushed them 6-0, they would come, asking for your jersey.
Get something from Nigeria
because it was obvious they could get something. Imagine, just look at some great save Iyama had. They could have got those goals at the back of the net. Had about 2 goals up front going to the second half. It would be very difficult for us to get victory. Not even talking about draw. But Oyeda have said a lot of things. What I mean, one thing about Keshi also is, the way he's not consistent with his, invitation.
Absolutely.
For at this moment, we need to be consistent because these other players understand the fight. They understand the mission, right? And we need to get the AFCON ticket in our kitty. But how do you make up of this? How is Keshi, making things happen for him going forward? Are we not going to see in the next game, seeing a different 10 players?
Hopefully not.
So, I think he needs to correct that. He needs to continue with this set of guys. Then, just like we said, bring in one or two players that can fight all. And I mean, you can get those players from the local league. When Keshi qualified for the 2013 AFCON, he made use of the home-based player, Godfrey Babona, Umba, Gabriel Rube, who plays for Caterpillars. And these are guys that got point on him on difficult home ground. If you go to Chad, you find it very difficult to play. You find pitch who are not even better than the pitch we offer them in Kaduna. So the atmosphere will not be good. The reception will be very, very poor. You might find a very poor dressing. Everything will not be professional. And these are players that are used to good facility. They might struggle. Yeah. But on the law, I think I should really understand his target. They understand his mission. And hopefully it will work for him this time.
And before I continue, let's just read some messages on Twitter. David Buki says, well, I think it's a good way to start the African Cup of Nations campaign with a 2-0 win against Chad. But we can do more and never slip off. And the guys in the studio actually agree to that. I really don't see what to celebrate about Nigeria defeating Chad nor Keshi as Super Eagles coach. Just coming from Prince Obiora. And Obiora, we've begged you to drop it. Coach Timmy Keshi will continue as head coach of the Super Eagles. The technical committee of the NFL believe is the right man for the job. And at the moment, I keep reminding us of what Tunde Koike said. We have entered a state of emergency. For Nigerian football, we just need to win. And Coach Timmy Keshi is getting that done. Let's just wish him all the best and keep supporting the Super Eagles of Nigeria as a keep searching for that 2017 African Cup of Nations ticket. Now, after the game against Chad, it was time for the Pitch Awards. The Super Eagles players, technical crew, administrators of the NFF, and of course the backroom staff of the Super Eagles of Nigeria, including the media personalities, came out for the 2014 Nigeria Pitch Awards. That's the picture right there. Coach Stephen Keshi, the technical crew, good to see Salisu Yusuf, and then Coach Valerie, Coach Ike Shoromu. Everyone turned up for the Pitch Award. What's it all about? To celebrate football excellence in Nigeria. Agboola Onsalami and Godfrey Obuabona. Obuabona didn't get to play because of William Ekong. But see, the guys are all smiles. That's what it means. When you beat Chad, when you get the points, it's all smiles. Kenneth Tomeru won the Defender of the Year award. That's him right there. And then that's the special recognition award being given to Channels Television 4, the Channels National Kids Cup. Guys, I told you, the Channels National Kids Cup is still winning. And then I was given to the chairman of Channels Television, represented by Sulaiman Alede. The chairman is also the visioner of the Channels National Kids Cup. And that's a special recognition for all that the Channels National Kids Cup is doing for grassroots football development. And that's Patrick Kugbe, representing the former governor of Cross River State. And this was actually one of the best moments of the Pitch Award. Funny Bone coming out of Gary Onazi to receive the Midfielder of the Year award. And I tell you, Onazi sometimes is so there you go. He said he should celebrate us. And they made it a fun night. 2014 Nigeria PGL goalkeeper Vincent.